Hi, I'm Vance, and welcome back to Repair and Replace. In this episode, I'll show you how to replace the diaphragm in a Delany Flushboy, Rex, or Presto flushometer. To begin, you'll need a diaphragm assembly, a flat blade screwdriver, a smooth jaw wrench, and a cloth. Flushometers or flush valves are just automatically timed self-closing valves. At rest, water is at equal pressure in the upper and lower chambers. This keeps the flexible rubber diaphragm closed tightly on the valve seat. When the handle is pressed, the relief valve opens and releases water from the upper chamber, which decreases the pressure. High pressure water from the inlet now lifts the diaphragm up and travels down the flush pipe. During the flush, some of the water is forced back into the upper chamber through a small bypass hole in the diaphragm. The flush continues until the pressure equalizes and pushes the diaphragm down onto the valve seat. The bypass hole size is extremely important for proper metering of water. Continuous flushing can occur if the bypass hole is blocked. If the bypass hole is enlarged, then the upper chamber will fill with water too quickly. Alternatively, if the diaphragm or relief valve is worn down or sticks to the valve, it can prevent the unit from even functioning at all. First, shut off the water to the flushometer. Remove the cap and use a flat blade screwdriver to turn the screw clockwise until the control stop closes. Next, hold down the handle to remove any remaining water. There might be some water inside, so it's best to place a cloth at the base of the flushometer. Use a smooth jaw wrench to loosen and remove the flushometer cover. Now, remove the diaphragm assembly. The flush volume is controlled by both the bypass hole size and the regulating screw. Now, diaphragms come in both urinal and water closet configurations, so be sure to select the right diaphragm kit. If the guide assembly and the relief valve are in good condition, then you can just replace the diaphragm. First, remove the relief valve. Next, unscrew the bushing and remove the seat and diaphragm. Separate the valve seat from the holder, and then discard the seat and diaphragm. Now slide the new valve seat into the holder. Align the new diaphragm and seat onto the guide. Next, hand tighten the bushing to secure the assembly. Finally, set the relief valve over top. Place the assembly onto the valve. Now, hand tighten the cap and secure it into place. Turn on the water by opening the control stop. Now, test the flushometer and adjust the control stop until you get a normal flush with a quiet operation. And finally, replace the cap. Now, if needed, the regulating screw can be adjusted to fine-tune the flush volume. Now, this will change how long it takes for the valve to reset. Now, turning the screw clockwise will decrease the flush volume, and turning the screw counterclockwise will increase the flush volume. The screw is very sensitive, so start with a half a turn and test the flushometer until you get the desired flow rate. If you found this video useful, then subscribe to our channel. We're constantly filming new content every week, so let us know what repairs you'd like to see next. Now, if you need a part for that repair, then explore our website. We stock thousands of hard-to-find parts, and we'll ship it out to you the same day. Thanks for watching.